Today, House lawmakers held a hearing examining voting rights across our nation. This hearing comes as states like Georgia and Texas move to pass what they're calling voter integrity legislation. Raquel Martin reports now in our top story at 5.
We cannot tolerate any voter suppression.
Democratic Congressman G.K. Butterfield says since January, states have introduced 361 bills to restrict voter access.
From Iowa to Georgia, bills are being advanced.
Sinister bills.
Illinois Democratic Congresswoman Sherry Bustos says Republicans have launched a crusade against the voting system, despite no evidence of widespread fraud.
We need federal legislation that helps clean up the corruption.
Voting rights advocates agree. Marcia Johnson Blanco said the federal government must prevent state voter laws that disproportionately harm low-income communities and communities of color.
Without congressional action, the 2020 elections and its aftermath may become an inflection point in our nation's history.
Democrats in the House already passed H.R. 1, a sweeping voter access plan, but Republicans in both chambers are staunchly opposed to the effort.
H.R. 1 is a power grab.
Kansas Republican Senator Roger Marshall says the bill is really about control.
It's meant to keep the Democrats in power forever and really be the end of the Republican Party.
It's the furthest thing from a voting rights bill. It's a Pay the Politicians Act. And it's a Protect the Politicians Act.
Illinois Republican Rodney Davis says states have the right to address election integrity.
They're doing their job.
President Biden is calling on senators to pass H.R. 1. The bill remains a long shot.
In Washington, Raquel Martin, KCAU 9 News.